Good morning, Wayzata. Today is December 5th. I'm Joe Kotke.
I'm Ethan Kleinite.
And I'm Caroline Hansen. There's quite a lot of news this morning, so let's jump right into it. The Senate passed the GOP tax reform bill early Saturday morning. According to the New York Times, the bill, which passed 51-49, will now move on to the House. If passed, the bill, clocking in at just under 500 pages, would decrease tax rates for major corporations from 35% to 20% beginning in 2019. However, according to the Washington Post, the bill would also make drastic changes to health care, with approximately 13 million Americans expected to drop insurance. The House is scheduled to vote on the bill in the near future, so stay tuned for updates on this story. Lieutenant General Michael Flynn has taken a plea deal with former FBI Director Robert Mueller after being charged with lying to the FBI. According to Go Minnesota News, Flynn admitted to lying to Mueller during the course of the still ongoing special counsel investigation into possible Russian meddling in the 2016 presidential election. The plea deal comes after it was discovered that Flynn was misleading the FBI last January in regards to his communications with Russian officials prior to the election. Flynn is expected to plead guilty. The Supreme Court passed President Trump's proposed travel ban on 6 Muslim-majority countries. According to the BBC, the ban will affect Chad, Iran, Libya, Somalia, Syria, and Yemen. Federal appeals courts in San Francisco, California, and Richmond, Virginia plan to fight the ban later this week. Of the 9 justices in the Supreme Court, only Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg and Sonia Sotomayor voted against the ban. Minneapolis's Minnehaha Academy will start clearing debris at the upper school this week. According to the Star Tribune, the campus cleanup is beginning this week after a natural gas explosion in August, which killed 2 and demolished most of the building. Students at Minnehaha Academy are currently attending classes at a former college campus in Mendota Heights. It is not yet known when the cleanup will be complete. Now back to Joe and Ethan.
Student volunteers are needed to serve as a small group leader for the 5th grade Meadow Ridge Kindness Retreat on Wednesday, December 6th. Please see Miss Badger if you can help. This is a school day event and it will be excused for absence.
Hour of Code will be hosting the Trojan Media Center on Friday, December 8th from 3:30 to 4:30. Activities will range from beginner to advanced. All students are invited and refreshments will be served.
Mindfulness class meets every Wednesday and is open to all students. Please speak to a social worker or a counselor in your floor office to get signed up. Now let's go over to Molly with the weather.
Good morning, Wayzata. We woke up to bitter cold this morning at 16 degrees with the feels-like temperature at -1. You can see what it looks like outside right now. Wind is blowing at 24 miles per hour and it will stay windy throughout the day. At 3 p.m. we will see the high of the day at 25 degrees. It will feel like 10. Tonight we'll stay in the low 20s and at 7 p.m. it will be 23 degrees. These cold temperatures are likely to stick around for the next few weeks, so make sure to bundle up and drive safe. While we are dealing with ice here in Minnesota, California is dealing with fire. A wildfire damaged 50 miles of land last night in Ventura County, California. At least 27,000 people were evacuated from their homes and 150 buildings were destroyed. One person was killed. There was another wildfire that made people evacuate in the Cagle Canyon area. These wildfires are caused by the Santa Ana winds. The fires are still burning, and according to the Ventura County Fire Chief, prospects for containment are currently not good. That's all I have for weather. Now let's learn about the Hour of Code.
I started playing basketball,
tennis,
football,
cuando era un niño.
Getting really good at something isn't easy.
It takes persistence and hard work.
It takes years of commitment.
Success isn't just about training your body.
It's also about training your mind.
Your body and brain get stronger when you push yourself.
I didn't always know I'd be a basketball champion.
Non sai mai cosa ti riserva il futuro.
Os futuros campeões serão os criadores.
Aquello con el talento para cumplir su sueño.
Con abota imaginavo futuro.
¿Qué quieres crear?
¿Qué vida puedes cambiar?
If you can dream it, you can do it.
You can bring any idea to life.
It's not going to be easy.
It takes time and determination like anything else.
You'll make mistakes, you'll get better.
You'll get stronger, and you'll succeed.
Push yourself.
Push yourself.
Push yourself.
Push yourself.
You did it!
Oh, respect. Anybody can learn. Só depende de vocês.
So, Lydia, I heard the first boys' basketball game is tonight.
Yeah, it is. Let's get started.
The first boys basketball game is tonight after a very successful season last year. They play Buffalo at 7 on the home court. Girls basketball also plays Buffalo tonight at Buffalo High School at 7:15. The Vikings are now tied for the best overall record. On Sunday, they played the Falcons and won 14-9. Jarek McKinnon scored the first touchdown, giving the Vikings a 7-3 lead. Kai Forbath gave the Vikings a 14-9 lead, which was what Minnesota held on to until the end of the game. The Pittsburgh Steelers linebacker Ryan Shazier was carted off the field last night and rushed to a hospital after he hurt his back early in a game against the Cincinnati Bengals. It appeared that he could not move his legs. The incident happened when Shazier tackled Bengals receiver Josh Malone and dropped to the turf in agony. Kevin Colbert, the Steelers' general manager, said, quote, Shazier will not need surgery on his back at this time and continues to improve, end quote. Now back to the anchors.
Driver education for January is now open for registration. There will be two sessions from 3:20 to 6:20 p.m. or 6:30 to 9:30 p.m. Pick up a flyer in the four offices with the rest of the details.
Club-wise, volunteers are needed for a regional spelling bee on Saturday, December 16th from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. at the Eisenhower Community Center in Hopkins. Full and half-day shifts are available. Stop by the Clubwise office on the second floor to sign up.
Amnesty International will have a meeting on December 7th after school in C120. There will be a discussion about the crisis facing Rohingya people in Myanmar and the larger issue of religious intolerance.
There are two spots left on the Costa Rica biology research trip. You can earn 3 college credits through going on this trip. The first two that register with teacher recommendations will be accepted. See Ms. Leland in A406 with more details.
On behalf of the Wyzetta Technical Crew, Caroline Hansen and Molly Laughlin, I'm Lydia Johnson.
I'm Joe Kotke.
That was Kai Christensen, and I'm Ethan Kleinite. Have a great day, Wyzetta.
This moment in the back of my mind, the time we stood with our shaking hands, the crowds in stands went wild. We were the kings and the queens, and they read off our names. The night you danced like you knew our lives would never be the same. You held your head like a hero on a history book page. It was the end of a decade, but the start of an age. Long live. This feeling, I passed the pictures around of all the years that we stood there on the sidelines, wishing for right now. We are the kings and the queens. You traded your baseball cap for a crown when they gave us our trophies.